To customize your recording workflow, Cubase offers a bunch of options. We're going to look at the common record modes, the audio record modes, and the MIDI record modes. For quick access, right-click on the transport bar and select all three. First, set up your common record modes. These determine what happens whenever you press record. Punch in and out means it stops and starts recording every time you press record. Re-record means it deletes the previous recording and starts a new one. And then these are all about where the recording starts. The cursor, the left locator or punch in point, or a selection, which can be just clicking, or an actual selection. Next, audio record modes. Keep history is the safest one. Whether you're recording in a cycle or overdubbing, it keeps all of your takes in lanes. Cycle history and replace. This keeps everything you do within your last cycle and deletes all the previous takes. So a cycle is a collection of takes you do in one go before you hit stop. And replace only keeps the last take. On to the MIDI record modes. Let's look at these top ones first. These define what happens after you've recorded, just linear or in a cycle. An important side note, if you're in the MIDI editor, you have to deactivate Record in Editor for these to work. New parts. It stacks the new MIDI parts on top of each other, and you still hear all the notes of every part. Some people record like this and then take the glue tool to merge all the parts. In that case, a more efficient way is to choose Merge, which will do that automatically. And Replace only keeps the last part. These bottom ones are all about what happens while you're recording, and they're also linked to what you've selected over here. Mix keeps every note you play. Overwrite replaces notes. Keep last only keeps the last complete lap within a cycled recording. Stacked, and you see it automatically selects new parts. This mode is just like recording in lanes for audio. It saves every lap in its own lane, and it mutes every lane except the last one. But you can unmute those. Shift U. If you're always going to unmute these, then you're better off choosing Mix Stacked, which is the same, but no parts get muted. And then you can select Automatic Quantize. If you're a beginner, I recommend these settings. Punch in and out. Record at cursor. For audio, keep history. And for MIDI, merge, mix, and auto-quantize. So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video, subscribe, and have fun making music.